Today we're going to review the operation and maintenance of a deep sea electronics control panel. Specifically, this one is a 7310. Deep sea uses a variety of different controllers, but the general layout is all the same. I'm going to begin with the general layout of the controller. You start with a stop button, which is also your reset button. So if the generator has a fault, this would be the stop and also the reset to reset the faults. To use the generator, you would need to put it in manual mode. You can see that from stop to manual, the LED illuminates to let you know that you are now in the manual position. The other mode of operation is automatic operation. This would be where you would use it to start from a remote location, possibly on an automatic transfer switch or a synchronizing device. This unit also comes with an alarm silence button. If you have an alarm and you wish to silence the alarm, you can depress here to silence your alarm. You would still need to reset from the stop button. The final button is the start button. This is used in conjunction with the manual mode button. So you would place the unit in manual. Then at that point, you can press the start button to initiate the start sequence. There are other functions of this control panel. These buttons here, which have LEDs, indicate for opening and closing breakers. This would be a utility breaker. By depressing this, when a utility breaker is connected with the panel, it would open and close the breaker. The same thing for a motorized genset breaker. Not all equipment comes with that option, but if yours does, you can operate it using these buttons. The next function is the menu buttons. This can be used to scroll through the various features of the control panel. This is the primary purpose of this training video, is to familiarize you with the monitoring and viewing of the various screens.